kids. It's time to hit the beach. And I brought along all the beach essentials. Well, most of the essentials. I've got some friends joining up with us later, and they're gonna bring some stuff too. Check out what I brought. Let's see here. We've got our sunscreen, some water bottles, sunglasses, a bucket, shovel, flip-flops, a hat, goggles, flippers, a bodyboard, some sand toys, a volleyball. Oh yeah, and one more thing, my beach towel. Hey, where did all my stuff go? JK, but seriously, do you remember what's under the towel? Can you tell me what color my sand bucket is? Who thinks the bucket is red? Who thinks the bucket is blue? And who remembers a yellow bucket? You were correct, Mundo, if you chose yellow. Now let's try that again. Oh, hey, one of my amigos just showed up and brought some awesome beach stuff. Let's see what he's got. Okay, we've got another pair of sunglasses, a little ice chest, a beach umbrella, a speaker to play some tunes, nice, and a necktie? Dude, who brings a necktie to the beach? Okay, whatever. Let's cover this stuff up and see what you can remember. All right, who can tell me how many water bottles are under the towel? Who thinks there are two? Who remembers there being three? And who is going with numero four? You were tags voracious if you said three. Oh, look, another friend of mine just showed up. Dude, throw coastal accoutrements right here. We're playing a game. Okay, we've got a beach bag, roller skates. Wait, what? You can't skate on sand. Hold on, a potted plant. Who brings a potted plant to the beach? A microwave? Where do you plan to plug that? Mittens? Why? Okay, that's enough. Let's drop the towel and see what we can remember. Okay, who can remember the color of the necktie? Who thinks it's red? Who's guessing green? And who is going with orange? You were right on if you said it was orange. Oh, let's cover everything up again, because I have another question for you. What was the last thing added to our assortment of stuff? Was it the mittens, the drill, or the microwave? Who says it was the mittens? Who thinks it was the drill? And who says it was the microwave? It was the drill. Dude. Oh, hey, my friend Bob just showed up. Welcome to the beach party, bro. No, let's see what beach belongings Bob brought. Okay, we've got a surfboard. Excellent. And a chalkboard. Okay, whatever. And a clipboard. A breadboard? A picture of the school board and a board? Bro, Bob brought boards! All right, well, let's cover everything up and see what we can remember. Alrighty then, here's the last question. Underneath my beach towel, how many boards are there? How many boards do we have? Are there 7, 8, or 9? Who says 7? Who's gonna go with 8? And who thinks it's 9? All right, let's count them out. Surfboard, that's 1. Chalkboard, 2. clipboard, 3. Breadboard, 4. School board, that's 5. Board, 6. And body board, that's 7. Congrats if you said 7. Well, that's it for game time, everybody. I'm gonna go and teach my friends some things about packing for the beach, because seriously though, right?
Hey, to be fair, dude, when you said bring your board, you could have been a little more specific.
Welcome everyone to another lesson in Gospel Journey. This is our second lesson in this new volume, like I said last week. We're very excited to be in this last part of the Bible. So, Janie, I have a question for you.
Yeah.
If you were rescued from a dangerous situation, would you run for freedom or stay behind and help others? Why? I can answer that about Janie without her answering it. I know she'd stay behind and help.
I would. Yeah.
I just know it.
Yeah, I would.
I don't know about myself.
Unless it was like somebody that could not move. Yeah, I probably wouldn't.
That's a really tough question.
You won't know until you're there.
No.
So.
All right. We're going to go to our activity sheets.
All right.
All right. This is Paul's second missionary journey. You're going to look at the clues and you're going to match the places that he went with the clues. So you'll put the answer in these blanks right here. Okay? And then the younger kids activity sheet is, oh, I love these. Find the hidden pictures.
Ah, neat.
We're going to play Pictionary. So teachers, whisper the words that are in the picture, the option one Bible Pictionary to the kids. And then the team that receives a point when the kids guess correctly. Anyway, just play Pictionary.
Yep, and we got a whiteboard.
Yep. Each word you drew comes from a today's Bible story. We will learn how they tie in. All right. So, our big picture question for this unit. What is our mission as Christians? Okay. Our mission is to make disciples of all nations by the power of the Holy Spirit. Okay. All right. Last week we learned about a very important meeting in the early church. The Jewish believers met together to decide if the Gentiles were saved by faith alone or if they needed to do more. Do you remember what they agreed to do? The early church leaders agreed that people were only saved by faith in Jesus. No one can earn salvation. That's part of the five solas. Scripture alone, faith alone, grace alone, Christ alone, to the glory of God alone. Right? And now it's time for our lesson.
The good news about Jesus was spreading. Paul and his friends, Silas and Timothy, traveled together and shared the gospel wherever God led them. At the city of Philippi, they went to the river to pray. Some women were there, and Paul started talking to them. A woman named Lydia, who sold purple cloth, was listening. Lydia was a worshiper of the one true God, and God helped her believe what Paul was saying. Lydia and everyone in her house was baptized. Another day, a servant girl met Paul and Silas. She had a spirit in her that allowed her to predict the future. The girl followed Paul and Silas, shouting, "These men are servants of the Most High God!" Paul finally turned and said to the spirit in her, "I command you in the name of Jesus to come out of her." And the spirit came out right away. Now the girl's owners were upset because she could no longer tell the future and make money for them. They grabbed Paul and Silas and dragged them to the authorities. The officials put Paul and Silas in jail. About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing songs to God. Suddenly, an earthquake shook the jail. The doors flew open and all the prisoners' chains came loose. The jailer woke up and thought the prisoners had escaped, so he took out his sword and was about to kill himself. "Don't hurt yourself," Paul said. "We are all here." The jailer took Paul and Silas outside. "Men, what must I do to be saved?" he asked. They said, "Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved." The jailer and everyone in his household believed and was baptized. Later that day, Paul and Silas were set free. Paul and Silas went to Thessalonica and told people about Jesus. Some of the people believed, but others were upset. Then Paul and Silas went to Berea. They were welcomed there until the people from Thessalonica came and caused trouble for them. Paul went to Athens and told the people about the one true God. Paul said that God wants everyone in the world to turn away from their sin and to turn to Him. When the people heard about Jesus being raised from the dead, some of them laughed. However, some people believed in Jesus. Then Paul went to Corinth. He met a husband and wife named Aquila and Priscilla. They were tent makers, like Paul, so they worked together. Lydia, the jailer, and many others heard the gospel and were saved. They were willing to listen and believe in Jesus. Paul and the other apostles preached the same message to all people. Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved.
Paul and Silas traveled to many cities, sharing the gospel with many different people. The story we read is known as Paul's second missionary journey. On this journey, Paul and Silas went even further into the world so that people could hear the good news. As they traveled, the Holy Spirit helped them boldly share the good news and gave them power to get through hard times. Who were some of the people who heard the good news about Jesus and believed in Him? That's question one. All right. Were all people always happy to hear and believe the gospel? That's question two. And who had Paul and Silas put in jail? Our mission is to make disciples of all nations by the power of the Holy Spirit. Like Paul, we can tell people, believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved. Okay? Lydia, the jailer, and many others heard the gospel and were saved. They were willing to listen and believe in Jesus. Paul and the other apostles preached the same message to all people. Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved. All right, it's time for questions from kids. for Pastor Kevin. How does someone become a Christian? And why is believing in Jesus the only way people can be saved?
Hi there, I'm Pastor Kevin. It's time for questions from kids. Philip from Dumfries, Virginia asks,
I'm not a Christian, so I need help trying to be one. How do I do that?
Philip, that is a fantastic question. I love to have answer these types of questions. And I hope once you get this answer, you share this with as many people as possible. The Bible tells us that in order to be a Christian, that we must first believe in our hearts that Jesus Christ is King and Lord and Savior. The Bible then tells us that we need to confess or say these things to God. When you're ready to do those things, tell someone like a Sunday school teacher or a parent or a pastor or another adult in your church, and they will help with this important decision. They will then tell you about what comes next. They'll tell you it is now time to be baptized. After baptism, Jesus Christ commands us to take communion. All the believers in Jesus Christ do those two things. They get baptized and then they take communion, or some churches refer to it as the Lord's Supper. Now, don't forget about the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit gives us the power to say we believe and trust in God. Now, I want to warn you that the hard part is living a life as a Christian. Doing the things that Jesus Christ wants us to do every day means we speak the gospel to our own hearts every day and trust in God and not in ourselves. We believe in Jesus. Why is believing in Jesus the only way people can be saved? I would love to hear from you. If you have a question, email me at gospelproject.kids@lifeway.com, and next time I might be answering a question from you.
In Chicago with our missionaries, Send Relief is a ministry that helps with community needs such as helping people affected by natural disasters. Chicago has a Send Relief Ministry Center that focuses its help in low-income, high-need neighborhoods. The ministry center is in an area known for violence, drugs, and other issues. The center offers counseling, youth camps, and sports leagues, and care for refugees. So let's watch our missions video.
Allow me to introduce myself. I am Chicago. I'm tall and I'm short. I'm black and I'm white. I'm from Mexico and Poland and China and Wisconsin. I'm Cubbies and White Sox and Bulls and Bears. I'm the Windy City and the Second City. I'm different from anything and anyone you've ever known. And yet, I'm just like you. Jesus loves me, too. Yeah, Jesus adores Chicago. Problem is, most people here don't realize that. And by most people, I'm talking about the 8 million of us who don't have what you have. Don't get me wrong. There are churches and believers here. They shout Jesus loves you as loud as they can. But when you're outnumbered 9-1, it's a little hard to be heard. That's why I wanted to introduce myself. Because the believers here need help. They need other believers who can pray and give and come help them. They need partners. They need what you have. I need what you have. I am Chicago. Nice to meet you.
All right. When we declare God's glory, we're telling others how great he is. We're so excited about who God is that we can't keep it to ourselves. We have to tell other people, just as Paul had to share the good news of Jesus with those he met. All right, so our verse for this unit is Psalm 96:3. It's the song we sang at the beginning, and it is, that is Psalm 96:3? Yes. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous works among all the peoples. So, once again, I'm going to say the big picture question, which is, what is our mission as Christians? Our mission is to make disciples of all nations by the power of the Holy Spirit. Thank you for being with us today. Let's pray. God, you are glorious and you do wonderful things. We want to tell others about you and your son, Jesus. Please give us opportunities to share the gospel with those who need to hear how they can be saved through faith in Jesus. Amen. See you next time.